fun, Squeaks and I were using our telescope to look at the planet Mars. Okay, Squeaks, what did you want to show me? Ooh, you're looking for a place to build a Mars fort? That's really cool. You know, scientists and engineers are preparing to send astronauts to Mars someday to visit or maybe even live there. We could all work together to learn more about our neighboring planet. It would be a big adventure, but there are some complicated problems that need to be solved before anyone can live on Mars. Hey, you love a science challenge, Squeaks. Do you want to think through some of these problems and see what ideas you can come up with to solve them? Great! The first big challenge of living on Mars is planning the important things you'll need to bring with you. Take a look at Mars. What do you think you'd need? Oh, you're right. A place to sleep is very important, and snacks are always a good idea. But even before that, we need to think about the very basics, like air to breathe and water to drink. Mars's atmosphere, or air, is different from Earth's. It's very, very thin, and there's almost no oxygen, which animals on Earth need to breathe. Including me. Astronauts would need to bring air with a healthy amount of oxygen or find a way to make it from the ingredients around them. There's a robot on Mars right now testing how to make oxygen from the air that's already there, kind of like plants do on Earth. However astronauts would get the air they need, they'd also have to find a way to keep it around them without it all floating away into space. Oh, spacesuits could help with that, and I love the idea of a giant bubble. So what about water to drink? Oh, a big water bottle is a good start. What do you remember about water on Mars, Squeaks? Yeah, there isn't much on the surface, and a lot of it is frozen. Scientists are trying to figure out which frozen bits of Mars are made of water and would be safe for us to drink. There may even be water deep underground, but we have to find it and test it before a thirsty astronaut takes a big long gulp. Let's look at another challenge. Gravity on Mars is a lot lower than here on Earth, so everything seems much lighter. I bet it would be fun to play in low gravity. We could jump really high. But low gravity also changes how people's bodies work. When astronauts spend a long time in low gravity, their muscles and bones grow weaker because their bodies don't have to work as hard to move around as they do here on Earth. Yeah, exercising can help. Astronauts need to exercise to help keep their bodies strong. Scientists are also researching to see if special medicines can help people stay healthy and strong on Mars. But in the meantime, I'll add some exercise equipment and a good routine to our packing list. How about one last challenge? Great. Astronauts need to be able to talk to people on Earth, but Mars is super far away. The best and fastest way to send messages through outer space is by using radio waves, but it still takes time for these messages to travel between two planets. During some parts of the year, it would take over 40 minutes to get a response. But that's not all. The length of one day on Mars isn't the same as it is on Earth. So one day you might try calling a friend during both of your lunch times, but a couple weeks later, it would be in the middle of the night for them. You're right, a good schedule could help a lot. And if we thought about it more like sending letters instead of talking on the phone or computer, that might help us handle the long wait. Oh, I miss you too, buddy. Let's agree that if we ever visit Mars, we'll do it together. Lots of amazing people all around the world are trying to solve problems like these so that humans can go to new amazing places like Mars. Working together, we might just find all the answers we need. Thanks to our partner, the Museum of Science, for collaborating with us on this episode of SciShow Kids. You may not be able to visit Mars just yet, but you can jet over to the Museum of Science YouTube channel to learn more about everything from the outer reaches of space to the inner workings of life science. And we'll see you next time.